Good evening. I'm Patricia Vallone with a CTV News update. After days of protest and social unrest following the police custody death of George Floyd, the White House is calling for a crackdown. In a conference call with governors today, President Trump said they had to get much tougher and arrest people. An estimated 4,000 people have been arrested nationwide. Meantime, after another night of disturbances in D.C., the city is extending its curfew. Mayor Muriel Bowser says tonight curfew will begin at 7 p.m. With more on the story, we turn to Byron Scott.
Tens of thousands of people took to the streets coast to coast across America this weekend for what started out as peaceful protests following the death of George Floyd, the Minneapolis black man who died when a white police officer pressed his knee into his neck for several minutes. In Philadelphia, police cars were set on fire, stores were burned and looted. In other major cities, violence erupted. Curfews were imposed in Atlanta, Chicago, Denver, Los Angeles, Seattle, and D.C., where police fired tear gas and stun grenades into the crowd that had gathered near the White House. I spoke a short while ago with State's Attorney Aisha Brainboy to get her take on the situation.
There's frustration that has been built up in this country because of the inequalities. And it's all coming to a head right now. And so while I don't support or condone any type of violence, and certainly the looting has to end, I do understand the pain, the anger, the frustration. But what also is happening is that people are using other people's pain and frustration and anger to perpetuate a lot of this violence. So it's not necessarily coming from those who are there for the right reasons. There are those who are using this moment to exact some just treacherous activities that has nothing to do with the death of George Floyd.
D.C. police have made a number of arrests, including some people from Prince George's County. Also, Delegate Dale Barnes is hosting a live Zoom conversation. It's called Being Black in America 2020. It's happening Wednesday, June 3rd at 6 p.m. To take part, log on to MarylandBlackCaucus.com/live. I'm Byron Scott.
The COVID-19 stay-at-home order in Prince George's is over, and the Phase 1 reopening is officially underway. Katira Jones has more.
After several months under a stay-at-home order, Prince George's County joins a number of jurisdictions that will begin reopening today. Under the county's modified Phase 1 plan, retail stores are allowed to open, but only for curbside pickup. Outdoor dining at restaurants is allowed. However, there can be no more than 6 people at a table, and each table must be 6 feet apart. Also, all employees must undergo a health screening before beginning their shifts. Barbershops and hair salons can reopen to customers, but by appointment only. Now, basketball courts, playgrounds, and fitness centers will remain closed. Now, meantime, the state's COVID-19 death toll is slightly up from last week. Montgomery County has the highest number of fatalities with 576. Prince George's has the second highest at 521. Reporting in Bowie, Katara Jones, CTV News.
A weekend shooting claims the life of a Atlanta man. Police say 49-year-old Keith Jenkins was shot yesterday morning in the 6300 block of Carter's Lane. Anyone with information on the incident is asked to contact authorities. An overnight crash in Suitland leaves 2 people dead. Around 11 o'clock, police say a car traveling on Suitland Road near Regency Parkway left the roadway and struck a utility pole. The cause is under investigation. Primary election day in Maryland is just hours away, but it won't be a typical election. Because of the pandemic, residents are voting by mail. Some in-person sites will be available, but voters are encouraged to mail their ballots. Can taking vitamins help guard against the coronavirus, particularly for those people who have low vitamin D or zinc levels? I spoke with a dietitian about recent research that shows there may be a link between low levels and hyperactive immune systems.
A lot of the people who are having COVID are having GI symptoms, you know, gastrointestinal symptoms. In this case, you're saying that would be a good idea, most likely, to supplement with vitamin D.
Yeah, and if you're having GI symptoms like diarrhea, taking zinc can also help. you know, retain some of those important vitamins and minerals and help with absorption.
Research from several different countries found that the sickest patients often had the lowest levels of vitamin D, and that countries with higher death rates had larger numbers of people deficient in the vitamin. The early research is yet to be peer-reviewed. A six-year-old Brandywine girl is hoping to take the makeup world by storm with her own cosmetics line. CTV's Keisha Butts has the details.
Meet Kalani Tremble, who at just 6 years old is whipping up makeup products for other girls her age. Her cosmetics line is called Glam Bakery. She currently sells lip balms and scrubs as well as glitter eyeshadow. Kalani also has makeup tutorials using her own products. I spoke with Kalani and her mother recently about where the idea came from.
Hey, Cupcake fans, and hey, Cupcake Squad. Today, this is my night routine.
It came from my mother. She thought of it a few years ago, I think.
She enjoys, like, playing makeup, playing with her Barbies. And so, given, like, the COVID-19 switch of things, I really wanted to instill in her the importance of, one, owning your own business, working for yourself, and making sure you have various streams of income.
Glam Bakery was created at the end of April, and so far, this young businesswoman has sold over 50 products. For more information, visit glambakerycosmetics.com.
Hi everybody, and welcome to this CTV Sports Report. Today we are talking baseball. Now it's an off day for the KBO in South Korea, but yesterday in the early morning hours, former Orioles and Bay Sox starter Tyler Wilson won his second straight start. It's the LG Twins beat the Kia Tigers 13-5. Wilson checked in and said he's still working on mechanics, still building arm strength, and still getting better as the KBO has ended its first month of their regular season.
It's getting better. You know, I'm still working through some stuff. You know, I'll probably say that for a while, I know, and it's probably getting old, but it's just such a unique way these last couple of months have unfolded that you really have to take it one start at a time. And it's not your typical progression. And I'm just trying to continue to trust in my process and my routine that has been so good to me over the last few months and seasons, and make adjustments where need be, but really focus on just staying healthy and putting together a good couple of skill work days leading into my start just to give my team a chance. And, you know, again, most important thing is just to try to stay healthy. I'm not super worried about arm strength or numbers or what it is. The only thing I care about is getting people out at this point. So just trying to do what I can to make that happen consistently.
Now, after a tough first start, Wilson is now 2-2 on the season with a 4.60 earned run average. Let's talk about other former Orioles and Bay Sox pitchers who are now pitching in the KBO. And here we go. Aaron Brooks, who pitched for the O's last year, is 1-2 with a 3.23 ERA through the first month of the season with the Kia Tigers. Adrasmer Despaigne is 2-0. He has a 1.69 ERA. He pitches for the KT Wiz. Dan Straley is 1-2 with a 2.70 earned run average. He pitches for the Lode Giants. And Mike Wright is 3-1 with a 3.21 ERA as he pitches for the NC Dinos. Moving on to Major League Baseball, the MLB owners and MLBPA continue to negotiate a possible return for Major League Baseball later this summer. The Baltimore Orioles joins other teams in Major League Baseball and continue to pay their minor league players. The Orioles will pay $400 a week to their minor leaguers through the end of June. Both the MLB and MLBPA have put together offers to return to play baseball, and negotiations continue. To Major League Soccer, where DC United got back on the field for individual workouts over the weekend, MLS and their players union continue to negotiate about a possible return for that professional soccer league. And that is your CTV Sports Report.
And that is your CTV News Update. I'm Patricia Vallone.